Hi students, very good morning. Today in this session we are going to read one more qualitative property that has been left out. That qualitative property whatever that has been left out, it is called as osmotic pressure. Right? So osmotic pressure. Is it clear? So before going to this special recall once. What is mean by diffusion? See, in first year we have learned the term called as diffusion in states of gases. So diffusion means movement of particles from high concentration region to low concentration region. See, movement of any particle, if it is solutions, it is the same thing. Movement of the entire solution. Okay, movement of the particles from high concentration region to the low concentration region. That is called as diffusion. Suppose if you take the container. Which is separated by cellophane membrane . This is semi permeable membrane . Okay, if you are having concentration something, you are having solution. You are having solution, this is of concentration C1, and you are having one more solution of C. Let us assume that C1 is greater than C, concentration. So assume that this is something like 5 molar concentration and this is 2 molar concentration. So obviously C1, concentration of this one in A side, B side. Of the graphics, so C1 is greater than C. See, what is diffusion? This is the movement of particles from high concentration region to the low concentration region. Means the particles should move from C1 to C. Up to when will it be moving? Means whenever the both the concentrations will become equal. The movement of the particles will be going on till there exists an equilibrium between the two concentrations. Till then there will be movement of particles. Right? This is called as diffusion. So again, saying example is, suppose if you light a agarbatti at the one corner of your room, what happens? After time passing, the entire room will be with the fragments of the dhoofis, right? In the same way, this one, the movement of the particles from high concentration region to the low concentration region is called as diffusion. And osmosis. There is one more term called as osmosis. Okay, let me take it. Osmosis. It is the movement of solvent particles. The movement of solvent particles from low concentration region to high concentration region. See here, the movement of solvent particles. See, we should be very clear. Here he is mentioning only solvent. See, in this case, he is mentioning particles. Particles means anything you can be, solute or solvent, both can be. Both will be moving from high concentration to low concentration. That is diffusion. See, in case of osmosis, there is movement of only solvent particles, not solute particles. Okay, only the solvent particles are moving from low concentration region to the high concentration region through a semi-permeable membrane. So this is called as osmosis. The movement of solvent particles from low concentration region. This is reverse to the diffusion. Low concentration region to the
high concentration region is called as osmosis. Are you clear with this?
Right. Let me represent this with pictorial representation. Okay. So look at this diagram. Not here. One container. Okay, this is you are taking a container and you are giving some pistons here. So there is a solution here. So you are taking the container. In that container you have two compartments, and those two compartments, let me take this compartment as A and this compartment as B. A and B compartments of your container are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. This is semi-permeable membrane. This is made up of something like animal cell. Cellophane bag like pig's bladder. This cellophane paper is made up of, sorry, this semi-permeable membrane is made up of something like animal cell or cellophane paper or cellophane bag paper, paper is cellophane paper or bag, and pig's bladder. Okay, by using these things you can prepare the semi-permeable membrane. And what is the action of the semi-permeable membrane? This semi-permeable membrane is having the capacity to allow only the solvent molecules. We remember this. This semi-permeable membrane accepts only the movement of the solvent particles. From okay, accept only movement of solvent particles. Let us take this one concentration C1 and this concentration C. What happens now? See, let us take the amount of these two animal concentration is negative. C1 concentration is greater than C2. Okay? Now what happens? From low concentration to high concentration. Means from C2. See, what is the meaning of osmosis? Again, I'm telling you. Osmosis. See, the movement of what? The movement of solvent particles. From, you can take solvent or dilute solution to concentrated solution. Right. See, in this compartment we have, sorry, in this container we have taken two compartments, then we are having C1 as the concentration in first compartment A and second compartment B. Those two are separated by a semi-permeable membrane, and we have one plate of together C1 concentration. Now what happens? The movement of solvent particles. This is the solution, right? It is the combination of solute plus solvent. The solvent particles are moving into the container, sorry, into the possible concentration compartment through the semi-permeable membrane. So what happens? If the solvent molecules comes into this container, what happens? The volume increases. So I can see that here is the piston. The water comes and then hits on the piston. So that this piston moves to this level. Getting me? The solvent particles are coming from this container to this container. So that the volume in this one, in this container, is being increased. So this extra solvent particles have come here and they are exerting some pressure. Okay, they are exerting some pressure so that the piston moves on and something stops. Whenever there is an equilibrium between these two concentrations, whenever C1 is equal to C2, this is equilibrium condition. In this condition, there will be the stopping of movement of the piston. The piston moving upside down will stop whenever there is an equilibrium, because the solvent particles will not come into this container. Right? See, this is called as osmosis. The movement of solvent particles from low concentration region to the high concentration region, so that the volume increases in terms of solutions. This is called as osmosis. So what is happening to osmosis in the resulting measure, right? Now what I am doing is, before this step, there is a, the solvent particles are coming into this container. I am placing one heavy substance here. I am placing half kg stone here so that it will stop. Generally this should move upside. And what I am doing, I am placing a stone which is exerting weight in normal direction, so it is exerting some pressure. Okay? If the pressure of this one is higher, it will move upside. If the pressure of upper one is higher, it will move downside. Let us assume that this half kg stone is stopping the movement of the solvent particles. So again, I am repeating, here the solvent solution C2 is present, here solution C1 is present. Generally, the particles should come from here to here. Okay? From low concentration to high concentration. Now what I am doing is, I am placing this stone on the piston so that even though the solvent particles are coming into this, it is not able to exert pressure on the stone. Means what's happening? There is no movement of solvent particles here. The coming of solvent particles into this container is happening. It is trying to exert pressure. This stone is balancing that pressure. Okay? This stone is balancing pressure, means whatever the pressure exerted by the water on the solution is equal to the pressure exerted by the stone. See, pressure exerted by solvent particles is equal to pressure exerted by the stone. So in this condition, what is happening in this container? They are exerting some pressure. Okay. What does it mean? This one is also exerting some pressure in opposite direction. Then these two are equal. Okay. These two at one point, for one term, will be equal. That point is called as osmotic pressure. See, the pressure exerted by solvent particles and pressure exerted by stone are equal. Okay. Why you are getting the pressure? Due to osmosis, you are getting the pressure. So this pressure is nothing but you are getting by osmosis. So this pressure is called as osmotic pressure. So that the piston should not move up. You getting me? This piston should not move up because it is balancing the upper and lower forces. That osmotic pressure is indicated by that osmotic pressure. See, the movement of solvent particles from low concentration to high concentration will occur. Okay, so that the volume should increase. Now what you are doing is, you are not trying to increase the volume. You are keeping opposite force something. When that opposite force is equal to the osmosis force, then that point is called as osmotic pressure. Okay, and osmotic pressure is indicated with the sign pi. And moreover, this osmosis will follow this osmotic pressure. Whatever you are getting into osmosis will follow what? We follow all the rules like that of gases, like pi depends upon what? This comes here, pi depends upon osmotic pressure, it depends upon the conservation. Okay, how much conservation is present? That will be known here. So pi n depends. Or you see, let us go to one gas state. In gas state, it states the gas loss, boils up. What does it say? Which is the inverse proportional to V at constant temperature? Charge up. Boiling is much more directly proportional to temperature. When constant is pressure. And charge up too. Pressure is directly proportional to temperature when boiling is constant. So the boiling will be ready. So ideal gas equation is equal to PV is equal to kT. The equation what we will be having for gases when all the terms are allowed. And in the same way, this way whatever we are seeing here, the same thing it is for solution instead of pre integrating D here. So pi depends upon the concentration. Okay? Now pi depends upon the temperature. If you write concentration, and you know that concentration is nothing but number of moles per volume. Means number of particles will be constant always and C inverse proportional to V. So you can write it as pi inverse proportional to V. Right. So whatever is known, pi proportional to C into V. Pi proportional to C, this is the first one. This is pi proportional to the second one. So if you combine these two, pi proportional to C. So from here, by combining these two equations, you will get this one. See, this one you can write it as pi proportional to N by V into T. If you say T is said, what happens? Pi into V is equal to N into V. If you remove the proportional, you will be getting pi V is equal to NST. Okay, this is one condition. You will be getting this value from here, then you have one more thing. This is one way. Pi proportional to N by V, you can write as N by V into T. And if you say T is said, it becomes pi proportional to NV. And no proportional, you will be getting NST. R is nothing but universal liquid constant. Here you will be writing gas constant, here you will be writing liquid constant. See here, universal gas constant is one. But then what is the value of this? It is the same value, 0.08 to 1. This is the condition. See, if you will write this one, pi, if you remove the proportional, it is equal to CST. Okay. Osmotic pressure is equal to CST or pi V is equal to NST. And S value is same, 0.08 to 1 as of the universal gas constant. Right. So this is the final equation what you should remember in your minds. Now, there are some terms. What are those terms? Means, hypocalic solution. Hypo. Hypotonic solutions means any solution which is having lower concentration compared to the other thing. Okay? Solutions having lower concentration are called as solutions having low concentrations are called as hypotonic solutions. Going for hypertonic solutions, hypertonic solutions, solutions having high concentrations, any solution which is having high concentration, then that is called as hypertonic solution compared to the other one. Right? High and low are the related terms. When we compare a solution to the other solution, if this solution A is having lower concentration, then that lower concentration one is called as hypotonic solution, and the solution which is having the higher concentration are called as hyperconcentration solution. Right? If you take one more term that is called as plasmolysis. Plasmolysis. Means what happens is you take a container, okay, or you take a cell. This is semi-permeable membrane. That is the reason to have a liquid in this. It is having something like concentration zero. And surrounding, you are having one more liquid. This one is called a simple conformation.
See, you are taking a plan cell.
Okay, is this
plan cell?
Okay,
is a plan cell with a liquid which is of some concentration C1. It is kept in a container which is having a solution C2 concentration. Right? Now assume that
C2 concentration is greater than C1 concentration.
Now we are assuming that this surrounding solution concentration is greater compared to solution concentration inside cell. Now what happens? This is the semi-permeable membrane which is separating the concentration C1 as well as the concentration C2. Then there will be movement of solvent particles from this side to from C1 to C2. So there will be movement of particles, solvent particles from C1 to C3. See, I will write it.
Movement of solvent particles from C1 to C3.
Now what happens if the plant cell will undergo shrinkage? Okay? Now this is the highly energetic cell, plant cell. What happens? Due to the movement of solvent particles, that one it gets generated in circular shape. After the shrinkage, it gets deformed into shape. Because the solvent particles have gone outside. What happens to the cell now? It has shrinked. This process is known as plasmolysis. Well, in the plant cell, keeping in a container of solution concentration C2, the concentration of the cell is C1. What is happening? Generally, according to the osmosis, there should be a movement of the solvent particles from high concentration to the low concentration region. So, C2 is higher, right? High concentration to the low concentration region. C1 concentration is low, high to low, right? Oh, okay. Just my correction here. C1 is greater than C2. A small correction for the students. Concentration this one is C1. This is C2. High concentration region, this one high concentration region, this orbital are moving into the low concentration region. So that it undergoes shrinkage. That undergoes shrinkage is called as plasmolysis. Okay? Then the next event is called as phenolysis. What happens? Taking a container cell, again I am going to explain this. We are taking a plant cell of concentration C1. It is present in a solution. Have concentration C2. It is also liquid is present. We are assuming that C3 is greater than C1. This is concentration, high concentration, this is low concentration. Right? Now what happens? Movement of molecules from movement of molecules will occur from where? From C2 to C1. So movement of solvent particles from C2 to C1 will occur. So what happens? The cell is first like this. After entering of solvent particles into the C1 from C2, what happens? It bursts. The cell becomes bigger. At one time, the capacity to tolerate the entrance of solvent particles will be decreased so that there will be breakage of the cell. Right? So, this is called phenolysis. The movement of the solvent particles from high concentration into the cell. So, what happens? The cell goes on increasing in size. After one step, what happens? It bursts up. So that there will be no linkage. The cell wall is collapsed. Then that is called as chemolysis. Right? Hypocaloric solution means a solution which is having lower concentration. Hypocaloric solution means solution which is having low concentrations. Hypertonic solutions means solutions having higher concentration of products. Hypertonic solutions. Plasmolysis means movement of solvent particles into the solution. So that what happens is that the shrinkage of the cell. And hemolysis means it affects the bursting of the cell. Okay, students, we shall take some problems with respect to the osmotic pressure and we will be solving those things. Right? Okay, students, look over these questions. The question is like this: calculate the osmotic pressure due to 5% vapor volume cane sugar at 50 degrees centigrade. At 50 degrees centigrade, it asks you to calculate the osmotic pressure. The options are here, like this 2.81 atmosphere, 3.4 atmosphere, 4.2 as well as 6 atmosphere. Right? Okay, you must try to pause the video and solve the question. 1, 2, 3. Right, I'm going to explain the answer. I know that you got the answer. Approximately, I will get the answer to something like 3.4 atmospheres. Right? The solution goes like this. So, pi is equal to something like concentration ST. Pi is equal to concentration is number of moles by volume into S into T. What is number of moles? See, 5% weight by volume. 5% weight by volume means 5 grams in 100 ml solution. That is what this means. 5 grams. So, one can write as Z into 1 by D into S into T. Then is nothing but weight. How much? 5. What is the molecular weight? He is telling K-shear formula. C12, H22, O11. So the molecular weight of this one, cane sugar, will be 342. Okay? C12, H22, O11. The molecular weight is 342. So N is nothing but weight by molecular weight into 1 by volume into S into T. Right? Weight is 5 grams by 342 into volume. What is volume? It is 100 ml. Total volume is 100 ml. So if you want it in liters, so it is 1000 by 100. Volume here, right? If you want it in liters, it will be 1000. Right? So what is S? It is 0.0821 into temperature. Temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. 15 means 273 plus 15. So it is 288. So approximately if you solve, you will get 3.4 atmospheres. So this is the answer. See, getting again, we can see pi is nothing but concentration nothing but concentration into universal equal constant into temperature. Concentration will be like this, number of moles by volume, and number of moles will be like this, by molecular weight, 1 by volume. If volume is in mm, then if it went by 1000, then because the answers are in atmospheres. So if pressure is in atmospheres and the volume should be in liters, then only R value will be 0.981. See, I am taking R value 0.01. Answers in atmospheres, the volume should be in liters. But here he has given 5%. Means percentage is per 100 ml. Per 100 ml solution per having 5 grams. So weight is nothing but 5 grams and the molecular weight of single H2O11 is nothing but 342. Volume is 100 divided by 1000, it goes into numerator, so that it comes in liters and 0.0821 and the temperature is 15 degrees plus 273. Approximately it will be written as 3.4 atmospheres. Right, students? Okay. Go to the next question. 250 centimeters of aqueous solution. Okay, is giving volume. Let me take volume is 200 ml or 200 cubic centimeters. Containing 1.26 grams of polymer, it is being weight. Weight is what? 1.26 grams. The osmotic pressure of the solution is being pi also. Osmotic pressure is 2.6 into 10 power minus 3 atmospheres. Okay, then this will convert that into liters, it becomes 200 by 1000 liters. Osmotic pressure is giving atmospheres by temperature. Already I have mentioned Kelvin itself, so it is 300 Kelvin. Calculate the molecular mass of the polymer. Okay? Pause the video and try to solve this question, students. Right. 1, 2, 3. Okay, what is the formula? Pi is equal to CST. Pi is equal to N by B into ST. Pi is equal to weight by molecular weight into 1000 by volume in ml into 0.0821 into temperature is 300 Kelvin. So, he is asking to calculate the molecular.
So molecular weight inside molecular weight of the particle equal to the weight 81.26 by 2.62 to 10 power minus 3 into 1000 by volume to volume is 200 ml into 0.0821 into 300. If you go for the calculation of the experience, then finally you get the value as 60,000 grams.
Okay. See, volume you have known, weight you know, aspect ratio you know, temperature you know. The same thing in place, all these things here. If you want to replace directly, ml here.
Okay.
So it will be the same. Otherwise, you take liters here, you will be equal to 1000. Okay, and finally, you will be getting the value as 60,000 grams. Did you get this answer? I hope that you are getting the answers. Right? And there is one more term which is called as isotonic.
Let me erase this. The term isotonic solution. See, if two solutions are having same osmotic pressure, if osmotic pressure of the solution is same, then those two are called as isotonic solutions. If two solutions are having same osmotic pressure, suppose this is solution 1 having osmotic pressure of pi 1, solution 2, this is solution 1, and this is having pi 2. If these two solutions are having same osmotic pressure, if pi 1 is equal to pi 2, then these two solutions are isotonic. If two solutions are having same osmotic pressure, then those solutions are called as isotonic solutions. Let us take one question with respect to this one. Okay, students, look over the question. So here, a 5% weight by volume of K-sugar solution, K-sugar, C2H2O11, is isotonic to 0.877% aqueous solution. So they were having aqueous solution as well as sucrose solution, or this K-sugar solution. Okay, let me take here. We are having K-sugar as well as B. What is India? K-sugar is 5% weight by volume. This one, and this one is 0.877%. Means nothing but 5 grams in 100 ml solution, and this one is 0.877 grams in 100 ml solution. This is clear. What is there? These two are isotonic. Means the measure effected by the K-sugar is equal to the measure effected by urea. Clear? Molar mass of K-sugar, this molecular weight is very clear, 342. Then the last thing, the molecular weight of this respective compound. Calculate molar mass of urea. Okay? See here, pi C means osmotic pressure of the K-sugar will be equal to concentration into CST. This one, pi urea, concentration means you can take here, concentration of this one, concentration of urea is this. You got this? What is the minimum? These two are equal. Means, if I take like this, pi C is equal to pi U. So this one, concentration of C to be S C is equal to concentration of U. Urea is this. These two are cancelled. This two will be cancelled because it doesn't mention any temperature. Means it is occurring at the same temperature. So that you should go for the concentration of K-sugar will be equal to concentration of the urea. And concentration of K-sugar is nothing but number of moles by volume, number of moles of K-sugar by volume of this one. Here also number of moles of urea by volume of this one, volume of urea. And volume is also same. Right? NC is nothing but weight by molecular weight sugar is equal to weight by molecular weight of urea. So molecular weight as mentioned is 3.2. Weight is 5 and this one 0.877 molecular weight. If you solve this, molecular weight will be equal to 0.877 into 3.2 by 5. So approximately you will get 60. So the answer is 60. Okay, similar, you can understand this. See, isotonic means two solutions are in equal concentration. Sorry, two solutions are in equal osmotic pressure. Okay. The osmotic pressure, this one you can write as CST, this one as CST. Concentration of medium is the concentration of the K sugar. And you know, SI is constant, 0.281 dose is cancelled. T, temperature is cancelled, because both are at the same temperature isotonic. And concentration of the K sugar will be equal to concentration of medium. And concentration can write as number of moles by volume, volume of C, because it is 100 ml, here also 100 ml. Volume can cancel, and number of moles of K sugar can be written as weight by molecular weight of K sugar, and here weight by molecular weight of the urea. So 5 by 3.2 is equal to 0.877 by molecular weight of the component that we require, and molecular weight that comes out to be approximately 60 gram per mole. Okay. Right. And the third thing is important, that is called as reverse osmosis. See, osmosis means you know, movement of the solvent particles from what? Low concentration to medium, high concentration. High concentration to low concentration means what happens? High concentration to the low concentration means osmosis. Low concentration to the high concentration is called as osmosis. Right? Now this is called as reverse osmosis. Anything that should occur reverse to the osmosis. Okay? Let us take the container like this. Separated by a semi-permeable membrane, concentration C1, concentration C2. This is C1 greater than C2. Okay, this is high concentration and this is low concentration, or addition is from low to high. Getting me? See, you are taking a compartment with C1 C2 concentration, C2 is lower and C1 is higher. Generally, osmosis is nothing but movement of the solvent particles from low concentration region to the high concentration region. So, what I mean is reverse of pressure, the solvent particles comes from C2 to C1 and they try to exert pressure on this pressure. So, I am balancing this one. This pressure will be assumed that this is exerting 0.5 atmosphere. And I am placing here a stone which exerts this amount of pressure 0.5 atmospheres. What happens? Now there is equilibrium existing between this, not equilibrium exactly, there is equilibrium here. So the pressure exerted by the solvent particles and the pressure exerted by the stone, the exhaust pressure is down by action, both are equal. So the piston will not move up or the piston will not come down. Okay? Now what? This is called as osmotic pressure. Whenever there is a balancing pressure from the outside as well as the inside, the water particle is initially here, they are not moving upward and the water particle is not moving downward. This pressure is called as osmotic pressure. Now what I have seen at the time is half kg stone, right? Half kg stone, which is exactly the pressure of 0.5 atmospheres. This is the equilibrium in this one. Now what I have done is I have placed one more half kg stone on this. This is also one more half kg stone. Now what happens? The pressure outside is greater than compared to the inside one. So this piston comes down because it exerts pressure in downward direction. Because it is greater than the outer one is having greater pressure compared to the inside one. So that it exerts pressure downside. Now what happens? From high concentration region to the low concentration region, the water particles will start moving. Generally, this is not a natural process occurring. This is the low concentration region. The movement of solid particles from high concentration region to the low concentration region due to the external pressure.
Different solutions. Okay?
Okay, students, and in the next class, we'll be dealing in last part of the